Did you see this great act of sportsmanship from jockey Danny Mullins? The rider offers a helping hand to weighing room colleague Jody McGarvey to stay aboard old supporter at Roscommon Races.
Green cap, Jody McGarvey. Here's what happens to him on board old supporter. Hits that, gets a crack in the face, and he's just about gone, but Danny Mullins grabs him. Get up there. Pushes him back into the saddle. What tremendous bit of sportsmanship that was from Danny Mullins, helping Jody McGarvey avoid a nasty tumble. But it's Gary's neck, but old supporter was pulled up after that. There's another look at it. And eventually, Danny Mullins ends up pulling up on Clondor Dude as well, but...
Two horses fell during a race in Ireland. One of the jockey's foot got caught in the stirrups. The other jockey quickly saw the danger and prevented the horse from bolting and causing serious injury to his rival. Gatlin may have ruined Usain Bolt's going away party with his surprise win in the 100 meters at the World Championships, but Gatlin still did his best to soften the blow by bowing down to third place finisher Bolt on his way off the track, a way of telling the people he knows what the Jamaican great has done for this sport.
The crowd drops. Justin Gatlin, with a time of 9.92 seconds, is the world champion here in London. The fifth fastest of all time at 9.74 seconds.
A young man with Down syndrome fulfilled his dream of seeing his heroes play on the court. And Zach Randolph was on hand to give the boy even more smiles.
Zach Randolph, and what a good guy he is. There's a young fan. I want that shirt.
And said thanks. That's all it takes.
I mean, Zach,
that's so cool. How did we get that on camera? That's just awesome.
Former LSU star Leonard Fournette took time out of his day to make a fan smile, signing his cleats and giving them away. Fournette gave the young fan, who was in a wheelchair, his cleats, but not before autographing both of them first.
Oh my God! Oh my God! Get on! Get on!
A runner gave up on a gold medal, but proved he has a heart of gold. The Kenyan runner gave up his chances of winning a race to help a competitor finish.
Yeah, your picture also. So we have the athletes coming one after the other in finishing, but a great race has run there by this, the man that has won for this.
He cannot go again.
He can roll to the finish, legs are giving up. Now he can barely cross the finish line.
I think the medics should just go there.
He should rush quickly to his aid. That's the spirit. Crossing the finish line, you can crawl, you can do whatever, but just cross the finish line. At what spirit, sportsmanship to the highest order. And now,
this is lovely. Wonderful. This is what sports should be all about.
Kipkemoi.
Oh, that's even Cheprot, I think.
Kipkemoi.
Cheprot carrying him.
Now the medics should just go, of course, and help out.
They should just rush there. It's Cheprot.
A woman was brought to tears when Shaquille O'Neal agreed to take a selfie with her during TNT's NBA playoff broadcast in Atlanta. Actually, brought to tears might be a bit of an understatement. She absolutely flipped out, especially when he turned and gave her a little kiss on the cheek.
This happened during the break.
Yes. It's hard being a sex symbol.
It's hard being a sex symbol.
UFC fighter Diego Sanchez made a dream come true for a fighter with Down syndrome who trains at the same gym. The two faced off in the octagon, giving Isaac, the Shermanator Marquez, a chance he would never be able to have.
Turkey's own, ladies and gentlemen, introducing Isaac, the Shermanator Marquez!
James noticed a young fan in the audience with a sign that read, "You are more than an athlete." James had a cab staffer give the young fan his arm sleeve to make sure the boy knew he appreciated the gesture.
This is one of the best things about LeBron. No matter what he does on the floor, for the fans, the kids especially, having Robert Brown give his arm sleeve to one of the little fans along the side.
LeBron James, and that was courtesy of King James is Cleveland Cavaliers security. Young man sitting over on the courtside seat.
You know how to impact.
A crying ball boy had to be consoled by a tennis star after he was smashed in the stomach by a 204 kilometer per hour serve. The brave ball boy was unable to fight back the tears after he failed to dodge the pile driver from Canadian Vasek Pospisil. Bulgarian player Grigor Dimitrov rushed over to comfort the youngster and gave him a sweatband to cheer him up.
Oh. Taking a blow to the stomach.
Sweatband. Come on, that thing.
Struggling. Poor thing.
Okay. Yes.
First turn. Wolf stopper Rui Patricio delighted a freezing young mascot by giving him his jacket moments before their clash against Watford.
Points from a possible 9 over the festive period. Depending on results elsewhere, it's given Watford a real chance of climbing another rung of the survival ladder today. And you can stay in touch with all of the ongoing football today thanks to the BT Sport app. BT TV and Sky customers can download the app and be in complete control this New Year's Day. And flick between all matches and see the goals as they happen without goal alert.
Belarus athlete took victory in the men's 74 kilogram category in Sambo at the European Games in Baku. But it was his post-fight gesture that stole the attention. An excruciating exchange unfolded at the end of the bout, with Papu and home favorite Emil Gasimov locked in a painful grapple. Papu eventually forced Gasimov to tap out, ending the fight, but only after he had inflicted serious damage to his opponent's foot. Gasimov struggled to hop out of the arena, with Papu winning back the partisan crowd by lifting the Azerbaijan athlete onto his shoulders and towards the medical bay.
Slav Papau. You have to feel a little sorry for Emil Gasimov. Absolutely exhausted. Some tears on the mat in Sambo. But there's only one emotion in the mind. Nice show of respect between the two. But it is the 31-year-old Papau who helps his opponent. And oh, look at that. There's a show of respect if you ever needed to see one. Gasimov of Gens. We carried down the steps here towards the medics. That's a lovely touch from the gold medalist. Well, martial arts is all about etiquette. They may be rough, they may be tough, but a heart of gold here from the champion.
Ronaldo and Messi have been inseparable at the highest echelons of their sport for more than a decade, as both have helped their respective teams to domestic and European trophies, scooping the majority of individual prizes to boot. But on Thursday, they demonstrated their rivalry may be a friendly one, because of the Juventus FC striker's invitation for a night together.
I was curious because we shared this stage 15 years, yeah. Me and him. I don't know if it's ever happened in football. Mm. The same two guys in the same stage all the time.
Yeah.
So it's not easy, no. as you know. And of course, we have a good relationship. We not had a dinner together yet, but
really?
I hope in the future.
You're in Monaco tonight.
In a video from Instagram, Doncic can be seen giving a pair of assigned kicks to two young fans after the game. The fans held up cardboard wishing Doncic well. In the game, one of the team's ball girls went straight to Ryan and handed over the foul ball to him. He and his brother were shocked and thrilled, but no one was prepared for his next move. In an instant, he handed the ball to the young girl behind him. No hesitations, he handed it over and smiled.
Especially from the right hand. As soon as he learns to recognize that pitch a little bit early. See?
It's not just his sporting achievements that has made Bolt a national hero in his home country of Jamaica and the world at large, but his altruistic deeds as well.
The only man in history to double back and win the Olympic 100 and 200 double twice. He did it in Beijing.
And Tom, there are a few athletes in the past 4 years.
Come back and like fist pounded me. You could see that I was like, do you want it? So yes, please. And as he gave it to me, all the crowd roared as well, which was good.
So what does it feel like to a young volunteer to have thousands of people cheer for you while speaking to one of the greatest sprinters of all time?